This video is supported by Orlando Informer.
I hope you have some snacks with you because this video's gonna make you hungry. Why is it gonna make you hungry? Well, I happen to have my hands on the preliminary menu for the Orlando Informer meetup. So we are going to eat our way around Universal today. The Orlando Informer meetup is next month. I believe the dates are the 5th and the 6th, also the weekend of the 11th and 12th. Nikki and I will be there on the 5th and on the 12th. And in case you are thinking about attending and you haven't gotten your tickets yet, they do have some available. They have sold out of some packages, but some tickets are still available. I think they are a little over 90% sold out though, so you're running out of time, so you need to make that decision quick. Hopefully, after you see what we can eat today for free, that will help you make up your mind. Now, I do want to point out the menu I have is preliminary, so it is subject to change, but I feel good about the stuff I'm gonna eat today, continuing to stay on the menu, so let's start. Let's enjoy some food, guys. A lot of good choices to eat here in Springfield. Starting here with Bumblebee Man's Taco Truck. All type of tacos we can have here. Chicken tacos, Korean beef tacos, carne asada tacos. Now, I'm not gonna have this today. I've shown this on many videos in the past. You know the tacos here are some of our favorite food in the park. Inside this little eating complex they have here in Springfield, we get the opportunity to have Krusty Burger, Cletus's Chicken Shack, Lisa's Tea House of Horror, The Flying Dutchman, and Luigi's Pizza. So I've done a video, the top 6 unique food items to eat at Universal. So I've already had and shown you guys the Krusty Burger on that video. So I think today we'll try the chicken and waffle sandwich here at Cletus's Chicken Shack.
And here's my chicken and waffles. So cute that it is topped with a tater tot, and it comes with curly fries. So let's dig in and we'll tell you what I think about it.
Well, all right guys, I just finished my first chicken and waffle sandwich. I've had chicken and waffles before, but usually it's just the chicken sitting on top of the waffle. Now the sandwich here comes with tomato, lettuce, and a maple mayo glaze. Of course you want the mayo for the chicken and the maple for the waffle. So overall, pretty good. I enjoyed it. And I did try it piece by piece. I tried it as a sandwich, and I did do like piece by piece, trying the waffles on its own, trying the chicken on its own, and things like that. But I want to mention, the good thing I like about Springfield is like the meals come with curly fries. I love curly fries, and the curly fries, you know, I had to stop myself from eating all of the curly fries. So there you go, our first little bite of the day. Let's move on down the road and try some more stuff.
I guess as we move along to the next venue, we can discuss some other things you can get here in Springfield on the preliminary menu. Krusty Burger will serve up Krusty Burgers, Ribwich, and Cletus's Chicken Shack will have, in addition to the chicken and waffle sandwich, a chicken arms dish. Lisa's Tea House of Horrors, you can get a Caesar salad, a turkey wrap, a veggie sandwich. The Flying Dutchman will offer the Basket O' Bait, which is fried cod, calamari, and coconut shrimp. And then Luigi's Pizza, you can get the Meat Likers Pizza or the Vegetarian Pizza. Duff Gardens, they'll have corn dogs. And I guess I should mention, if you are not at the meetup, you're just here visiting and you have to buy the chicken and waffle sandwich, it would be, the platter would be $13.
And I don't know if you guys have noticed, it's a little wet today, a little cloudy, a little bit of rain, a lot of wind. We are in the cone of a tropical storm. It ain't gonna stop me though. It ain't gonna stop me.
Into Diagon Alley, where we're gonna have the options during the Orlando Informer meetup to get some items from the Leaky Cauldron, the Hopping Pot, the Fountain of Fair Fortune, and the ice cream place here. So I decided to go with the cottage pie from the Leaky Cauldron and check out my seat. I got a good table right here by the cauldron. Some other things available here during the meetup would be the apple and beet salad, a garden salad, and then also hot butter beer will be available here. And here is the cottage pie. Comes with a little garden salad, your choice of dressing. I went with your basic ranch dressing. But let's dig into this and see how we like it. Actually, let me start by just kind of cutting into it and letting you look at the inside of it.
I just finished the cottage pie. I knew I'd like it. It's basically meat and potatoes with a little bit of vegetables, and it does come with that salad. But previously, over at the Three Broomsticks, I did have the shepherd's pie, and they're pretty much the same, except the shepherd's pie, of course, is lamb, whereas the cottage pie is all beef. I knew I would like it, and I did.
Now, if you're here and you're not at the Orlando Informer meetup, that cottage pie is gonna run you about $16. Now, if you do come to the meetup, of course, it's free. And then some other things we can have here in Diagon Alley would be Florin Fortescue's ice cream, various specialty ice cream flavors. At the Fountain of Fair Fortune, that's where you're gonna be getting your non-alcoholic beverages, such as pumpkin juice, lemonade, iced tea, ghillie water, butterbeer, and frozen butterbeer will be there. The Hopping Pot here in Diagon Alley, that's gonna serve up regular butterbeer, ghillie water, and pumpkin juice, according to the preliminary menu that I have in hand.
So far today, we have been lucky in the fact no heavy downpours, just a few light sprinkles from time to time, but the wind is picking up.
Now, it is not open for me today to show you and try some of the food, but Richter Burgers will be open for you guys during the Orlando Informer meetup on December 5th and 6th, and then again on December 11th and 12th. And again, this menu is preliminary, subject to change, but you should be able to get a hamburger, a cheeseburger, a small garden salad, chocolate and or vanilla milkshakes, the Beyond Burger and French fries.
So even though it's not open today, I have had all the burgers here at Richter's, even the Beyond Burger, they're all good.
And since I am kind of giving you an update on the Orlando Informer meetup, I guess I should mention some of their hotel rooms, their discounted rooms. They have added some discounted rooms at Portofino Bay. They start at $214 a night for the first weekend, which is December 5th and 6th. And then they go down to $199 a night for the second weekend of the 11th and the 12th of December.
Of course, Louis Pizza is going to be open during the Orlando Informer meetup.
Some items on the preliminary menu here at Louis include the fettuccine alfredo served with grilled chicken, Caesar salad, spaghetti and meatballs, garlic breadsticks, cheese pizza, pepperoni pizza, and vegetable pizza.
Even though it's just a preliminary menu, I'm gonna step out on a limb and guarantee Louis will have pizza during the meetup. Stay tuned because I have a couple of cool things coming up I should have teased you with at the beginning of the video, but I forgot. Couple cool things you're really going to like hearing.
Finnegan's Bar and Grill will be serving up some dishes. I'm going to pop in here right now and try something I've never tried before. So here is the preliminary menu for Finnegan's for the meetup dates of the 5th and the 6th and 11th and 12th of December. You can get an apple beet salad, a vegetable pasta, Cornish beef, hot wings, bread pudding. I'm going with the hot wings.
I should mention the regular price of the chicken wings, the hot wings, is $13.
And here are my chicken wings. I went with mild and a ranch dressing. I should note, for the Orlando Informer meetup, I am not sure of the serving size for this dish. Obviously, if I got a burger someplace, the burger would be the same size. I'm not sure of the serving size of the wings for the meetup. Now hang on, because things are about to get messy here.
Now the chicken wings, that was my favorite of the day, but let's be honest, I don't think I've met a chicken wing that I haven't liked. Actually, to be honest, I don't like the wings from Hungry Howie's. And now we know Hungry Howie's will never sponsor a video. But that's okay. The chicken wings, the hot wings there at Finnegan's, very, very good.
So here's the new thing happening at Universal this holiday season. It's the Universal Holiday Experience featuring Macy's parades and parade floats and everything. That will be available during the meetup for you to walk through, see the Macy's balloons and the floats and everything. So there you go, another reason to meet up at the meetup.
The Monster Cafe will be open. Now that hasn't been open since like the beginning of the year before the shutdowns. And the Monster Cafe has not reopened since the park has reopened. They've been using it, I think, as an employee break room, but during the Orlando Informer meetup, the Monster Cafe will be open once again.
And it looks like the preliminary menu for the Monster's Cafe will feature a rotisserie chicken, the Mummy vegan sandwich, the Invisible Man brisket sandwich, roasted cauliflower and broccoli, French fang fries, and crypt cookies. There is one more place I want to tell you about as far as food regarding the Orlando Informer meetup, and that's going to be down Hollywood Boulevard at Mel's Drive-In. And it looks like our preliminary menu is going to feature a hamburger, a cheeseburger, chicken fingers, chicken and avocado sandwich, french fries, a small garden salad, apple pies, and vanilla and chocolate milkshakes.
And since we just had the hot wings, I think I'm going to go with the vanilla shake. I just had the chocolate shake last week, so let's go vanilla to cool off our lips from those hot wings.
And here it is, a regular vanilla shake. Regular price, $4 plus tax. And again, I've said this before about the chocolate one, it is more like a Frosty. You need a spoon more than you need a straw.
Now with the vanilla one, the consistency is still like having a Frosty, but the taste is more like homemade ice cream. And it is very, very good. I think I prefer the vanilla to the chocolate.
It was not my intention to eat all of this, but look what I did. It was that good. I have to remember to get this when I'm here during the meetup. Oh, a little bit of a brain freeze. A little bit of a brain freeze, though.
Okay, guys, I think that will do it for today. Thanks for hanging out with me. Now, the thing is, I don't know right now, should I go home and take a nap after all this food? Or should I go to the gym and try to work off some of the calories? I think the nap's going to win. But I tell you what I'm going to do for you guys. In the description box, I'll leave a link to all this Orlando Informer information. Go check it out when you get a chance. And as always, don't miss the magic, don't miss the fun. Thanks for watching Rich Flicks. Now, it's time to take a nap. Or go work out.